Velocity Restorations, a company I've been following for a while on Instagram, they do what I think is, are absolutely cool restorations of old Ford Broncos, mainly. They do other cars as well. And Tom from Velocity is going to show us the cars because they have them here again at one of those villas, one of those houses outside of the direct environment of Pebble Beach, and we're going to get to drive one. I don't know which one they're going to give us. I love them in all kinds of different colors, but let's see. First of all, Tom, it's so fun because I walked onto their booth at Quail and he came towards me and said, oh, we texted on Instagram. And that's how well you meet people at this event. As I've said many...
You wanna
look at this. Wow. They do a lot of muscle cars, restorations, but mainly what I know them for, what I love them for, is restorations of old Ford Broncos. Like the beauty that we have. In. By chance, it's the right color. So, Tom, what is this? How do you do it? How does it work?
So the company's about 12 years old. For the Bronco itself, we've built just shy of 450. Wow. So this is kind of our staple yes. product. We build on an assembly line. So normal kind of restoration, resto mod problems are, you know, placing orders, not knowing when the cars are going to come, whether it be procurement problems, right. getting parts, things like that. We fix that. We guarantee a 14-week lead time.
Okay.
So we have just shy of 150 staff in Florida. Mm-hmm. We have 135.
So you're based in Florida.
We're based in Florida. Yeah. We have 135,000 square foot facility there, mm-hmm. and we do everything in house. Okay. You know, paint, powder, sandblasting, electrics, every single thing. Even the interiors are done.
Can I come next time
Absolutely.
I'm in Florida?
Absolutely. Yeah, okay. We'd love to have you around. You want to take a look around this one?
Yeah, of course. So this one obviously is not a standard vintage Bronco. So what's your starting point for this? Is it always a certain model or a certain build year, or is it, how do you start?
For Bronco, they're all 66 to 77.
Yeah.
And there were some nuances between those years, but ultimately they were all the same.
And you can utilize any of those platforms?
That's correct, yeah. Okay. And we procure the donor vehicles as well. Yeah. So the customers come to us, they have the car. They don't need to yeah. bring us anything.
Okay. Know? And then you strip it completely.
Correct. So we start with the donor. On this particular vehicle, we have the original chassis underneath mm-hmm. it. So we've done some repair work and then powder coating preparation.
Okay. Yeah.
We do also have a brand new chassis as an option as well under our yeah. vehicles.
Yeah.
We work with Roadster Shop on almost all of our
okay.
vehicles.
Yeah.
For chassis and
probably
chassis
a completely different price point, right?
Actually, it's not yeah. that much different.
Okay.
I think we charge about 4,000 or 5,000 extra.
How much is a car like this?
As it stands here, yes. you'd be looking at just shy of 300.
Okay.
This has got some extra features on yeah. it. Our base price is 250. So okay. there's not really that much variance. We yeah. include a lot with the base package.
Okay. You're playing around a lot with color.
Yes.
Is there anything that, what do your clients prefer? Is everybody taking something else, or are there colors that you will say you sell the most?
There's some really, really popular colors okay. that we sell repeatedly. Classic American colors, Brittany Blue is really popular,
yeah.
Anvil Gray, which is
yes.
actually more of a blue.
Yeah.
Obviously the blacks are quite popular,
yeah.
and then Swatter's Blue, which is a deeper blue. So those gray blues are really popular, but more recently, actually, as I've joined the company, maybe with a little bit of a European influence,
mm-hmm.
I've started experimenting a bit
okay.
more. So we've done some Nardo Grey trucks. I've
yes.
done. I did a pink truck, which
yes.
we ended up selling three more from. We did one
right.
pink truck, and it went super viral.
That's because that's what I'm seeing, and what is catching my attention nowadays in your lineup are the bright ones.
Right. Part of it is about experimentation
yes.
as well. So if I try something, sometimes it doesn't work. Maybe the car sits around for a couple extra weeks and we want it to,
mm-hmm.
till we find the right buyer for it.
Yes.
But other times we try something and it really works. You know, Boxwood Green, we've sold a ton of those cars.
Okay.
We didn't think it was going to be so popular. It has been, especially with our Ranger package. We do a midnight red, almost mm-hmm. like a cherry red that becomes really deep red when you
yeah.
when the sun
oh,
hits
that.
It.
Yeah.
You know, stuff like that we've kind of tinkered with and toyed, and some of them catch on, and some of them, you know, you think, okay,
yeah.
well, you'll always find the right man or lady for that
mm-hmm.
car. Sometimes it takes a bit longer.
So what's happened? How did it start? What is it now?
Well, how did it start?
I can count, obviously.
Very, very differently, right? So most people, when they see a classic Ford Bronco, if it's had some kind of light restoration, it's
yes.
only got the 302.
Yeah.
This is a brand new Generation 3 Coyote V8.
Mm-hmm.
And so it really is a very, very different power plant. Produces around 460 horsepower.
Yes.
Coupled to a 10-speed automatic transmission.
So it's interesting because this is, in essence, a resto mod, and you're not trying, engine-wise, to restore it back. So you're not taking the original old engine and then completely restoring it.
No.
Such as we would do, for example, with the 280 SL Pagoda or a W111 at Brabus Classic.
Yep.
But you're saying, let's put a new power plant because it's going to give us a lot more power and different driving dynamics.
Correct. And I've been in this industry almost 10 years. The truth is, whilst quite a lot of people like the idea of a restoration, a full nut and bolt restoration, I've done a lot of those. It's not for everybody the end product, right?
Yeah.
For some people,
it's a different kind of product.
Right.
Yeah.
Some people, they want to drive the car every day. They don't want to have to worry about you know, lots and lots of service. This is what this does. Our tagline is literally modern classics.
Yeah. So when we drive this one, I think we're going to discover that it drives differently.
Good.
Ooh, wow. See, running board. Also again. Oh, sorry. Something that wasn't there.
Yep.
And something that you might know from our cars, like the 6x6, for example. Or XLP, useful, and what I like is that it doesn't disturb the looks.
No,
it disappears. I like that.
You've
done very bright interiors, exteriors, reduced brown, black. You know what my impression is? It is what it promises to be. It is when you see it on Instagram, on YouTube, on your website. Come here, I get in. That's exactly what it promises to be. It's a Bronco. I like the steering wheel, stick shift. Nice. So, Niklas, are we going?
Yeah.
So, I'm noticing automatic.
Yes.
There's no clutch.
Yes. Almost all the Broncos are automatic.
So I can go backwards. This gives us a first opportunity to drive backwards. And we notice it drives backwards. Check. Kind of a cool feature to have in a car. Where did the idea come from?
Stuart and his friend bought one Bronco.
Yes.
Fixed it up, sold it.
So passion driven.
Right. Here you go. Foot down. Fire.
Wow. Yeah, let's not overdo it. Scenery here is absolutely beautiful.
It's unbelievable.
It drives again, you know, I have to say, it drives exactly like I would expect it to drive. Wow. This is for me, such a cool, relaxed, charming old-timer. A car that nobody will look at and go, you know, and get jealous. This
Nobody
is something people look
cars.
At and you know, immediately give you a thumbs up.
Yeah, exactly.
That people want to jump in, try out, have fun with.
It doesn't matter.
Listen to the Beach Boys and just have a good time. Can I put it up here? Oh, is it allowed to put it up there?
Yeah, you're fine.
Here we go. Okay, quick stop, switch the car. Now we are in a K5 Blazer. It's a bigger car.
It's
the more expensive car. It's almost double the price. Two-thirds of the price.
Yeah, that one isn't so highly optioned. This has everything. Fully custom-made, 3D printed.
So it is kind of the bigger, in your portfolio, the bigger brother of the Bronco work.
This is like the big boy.
Yep. Okay.
Correct.
Here we go, Let's talk engine. This is the bigger brother of the Bronco. How much power does it have?
This has just shy of 500.
Okay.
And it's the LT1, so the GM power plant.
Whereas the Bronco was 462, right?
460.
And 460.
Yeah, that's the Coyote, so much more lower end torque in this car.
Switching it on and driving the first turn, you can already feel this is a different animal. It is a bit stiffer, and it feels more like a car that is usable as a daily.
This is much more of a family wagon, especially with a hard top on this.
Yeah,
really a daily driver.
As somebody who hasn't driven a lot of classic Chevys or a lot of classic American cars, the question that I'm asking myself is, am I getting into this, missing anything? Mm-hmm. Or am I just getting into this, even liking what I find? And I'm catching myself liking what I find.
Right.
Over its original thing. For example, I would never have an old timer that doesn't have a proper stereo system in it.
Yep.
At Brabus, we call it Sound Extra. We put it in. You can connect your phone via Bluetooth. For me, that's a minimum requirement.
You got power windows in this.
Yeah.
All things that you'd expect in a modern car.
Yeah, it's a bit more stable. Hey, when you talk about changing the setup on the Bronco, can you, if somebody wants a bit of a sportier setup, what do you do? Do you lower it a bit? Do you change?
We wouldn't lower it a bit. Honestly, there's not that
so
there's, much
it's gonna it's gonna yes
Bronco.
Okay, yes, yeah. Those cars, both of them are, you know, you put your arm on the, you put your arm out the window, put on some nice, put on the Beach Boys and just drive. Had to do it.
Yeah.
Do I turn around?
You can turn around, or if you want to swap into the Mustang, you can do that.
Yeah, let's swap into the Mustang quickly. So a lot of people are going to get in this car without maybe without having the comparison to an old Chevy in its original form. They're going to say, oh, it drives. Yeah, it's nice. Without actually knowing how much work goes into making this, because you've got to re-engineer this thing from the ground up. It doesn't run just like this, you know? Until it does that, there's a lot of work involved. Okay, so let's switch it for a third time and jump it to the Mustang.
Lap belts in this one.
I know.
You want to put them on before you shut the door.
I want to put them on before you shut the door.
They're just retractable, so it's quite hard to.
There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a new clutch. Oh, come on, this is nice. What a nice car.
This is Cody's baby.
Oh, yes. Whoops, sorry. That's a bit more torquey than the Bronco and the Blazer. Drives really, really nicely. If you shift to one in any of the cars, it's you need a bit of gas, and here you don't. So,
just pull it straight into the drive, we'll sort it out.
Wow. Three cars, completely different experience. Same idea. Resto mod. In other words, combining old ingredients with new ingredients. And I have to say, it's been a fascinating experience. Tom, thank you very much.
Great to meet
you. This has been great. Absolutely. Thank you to you and your team for making this possible. I just told Nicholas, you know, three different cars, three different experiences, three different animals. Same idea, same ingredients. You take some ingredients from the old world, the vintage car world, and a lot of ingredients from the 2023.
Absolutely.
The new world. And you combine them into Restomar packages that were super interesting to drive. So,
good.
Thanks.
We put a lot of work into our videos, so please don't forget to like and subscribe and become a part of the Brabus community.